Hello, Gundam fans, this is Prime92, and today I'll be looking at the SD cross silhouette Zaku II Char colors. And I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So yeah, this is basically the Zaku II I already reviewed, but it's in the Char colors instead of green, and it has the command antenna. But it's still a great looking kit. I really love the puffy sticker they use for the eye. The only sticker on the kit, actually. Everything else is colored plastic, and although this is the gray SD interframe, because they don't actually have a colored SD interframe, which is interesting, it still looks fine, I feel. Nice detail all over. Of course, you do have the movable model eye. You can get the head off. Little lever down there. So you can it's very easy to move. It doesn't fall, but it takes very little effort to actually make it move, which is really good. And the head is ball-jointed, and it can hinge up and down a little bit. The arms are ball-jointed. The shoulder armor here is ball-jointed, and then the actual shield here is ball-jointed, but it is kind of limited. The arms can go out about that far. They're also ball-jointed. The wrists are ball-jointed. The waist can rotate until you pull it out some, and then it's ball-jointed. The hips are ball-jointed, and the feet are ball-jointed. So same as before, but it's still decent for just the SD frame. And then, of course, the Zaku has a crap ton of weapons. First off, you have the leg-mounted missiles. Which, sure, they're all black, and they're hollow in the back, but I think it's pretty good. The fact that they're hollow at the back, it does kind of look like the ends of the missiles. So I think they did a pretty good job with those. Then you have the Heat Hawk, which is missing the clear piece, and I don't see it anywhere. Well, it should have a piece at the end here, which I don't know what happened to it. Pretend it's there. Anyways, it goes into the hand. It does fit pretty well with the thicker part there in the hand. And then we have the machine gun, which has a sticker for the sensor. The part here doesn't move, but the handle moves, the extra one. And you can remove the ammo clip if you want to. It also fits into the hand rather securely. It's pretty tight. And then you have the bazooka, which also has a sticker for the sensor. Extra handle here moves, and the main handle moves, which I do like. Not sure how I did that, but I did. There we go. But yeah, I like the fact that the main handle moves. That's pretty good for SD. Now you can store it on the back skirt. Right like so. Of course, you can put it in the hand, and because of that movable handle, it's very easy to get over the bulky shoulder armor. So just as is, it's pretty good. But of course, I want to give it the cross silhouette frame, and they did come out with a pink Zaku II cross silhouette frame. Now they also came up with a green one, which I've already put on my old green Zaku, which I'll show in a little bit. But first off, let's get this guy into his cross silhouette form. And here's the SD Zaku II Char colors in the cross silhouette form. Now you can, if you don't like the more angular biceps and thighs, you can get the upgrade set in either pink or green now, so they can be more roundish, which would make more sense. I might get them, I don't know yet. I don't really have too much of a problem with what they are now. But yeah, I think it looks much better. More, it's like I've said before, some models do benefit from the longer joints, and some look a little weird. But the Zaku II, I feel, looks really good. And of course, the head's about the same. It's a little easier to go up and down at the neck. Now you have the forward and back at the torso. You got the elbow hinge. You got the thigh rotation with the knee hinge, and the ankles do move a little easier because they're a little lower down. So, the articulation, of course, much better now because of the new cross silhouette frame. And of course, you can give it the same accessories. I did take the Heat Hawk off my green Zaku II because I can't find that clear piece. It just disappeared. So I can still use all the accessories. Nothing's changed. Get those missiles on there, which I really like the missiles. The fact that they include those on the SD is really cool. And there we go. Our Char Zaku all ready to go. So let's compare it with the green one, which I have already said I put the green inner frame on it, which looks so good. They look great together. And then we can also compare it with some Gundams. There's the Wing Zero Custom and the RX-78-2. So yeah, if you have the green Zaku II cross silhouette, I'd still say get the Char one, because of course it's Char's color, so that is pretty iconic. And the Zaku II is a great cross silhouette. Really, I still have yet to have a cross silhouette kit that I don't like. They're all really great. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.